as we're just about ready to get this one started. Welcome to 2K Sports. We have the NBA coming up. Great to have you with us. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan. And joining us tonight, Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke. And reporting from the sidelines, our very own David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Mikal Bridges is a big part of the Suns' growth into a powerhouse. Coach Monty Williams said of his two-way swingman, I believe he has every intangible, talent, and quality to be a glue guy in that starting lineup. Mikal has an edge to him. Guys respect the heck out of him because he competes every day. Kevin, I compete every time you throw it down to me.
You do. And you're a great competitor. DA, it is an honor to be on this broadcast with you each and every game. And certainly Bridges one to watch. DA, thanks. Let's see the stat sheet here for him.
And in the last five games, he's made a bunch of hustle plays on the glass more than anywhere else. His rebounding totals in these games shows a dramatic increase from his numbers during the rest of the season.
Looking at the starting five for the Phoenix Suns. Up it forward, they'll have Bridges and Crowder. The star backcourt of Paul and Booker are out there. And it's Ayton in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for Utah, O'Neal at the four, while Gobert stands tall at the five. Conley is the point with Mitchell as the two guard. And it's Bogdanovich in at the small forward. And the kind of game fans love to watch, Greg. Two offensive teams going head-to-head.
And the rules today favor offense. And that's why league-wide scoring continues to rise.
Now, here's Bogdanovich. Turned in an outstanding game against Denver. Outside Crowder. Ayton sets the pick for Crowder. And so the ball out of bounds. Gobert touched it last. Paul outside. Six on the shot clock. The Suns need to get a shot off. Crowder with another miss. So it's Bogdanovich who brings up the ball for Utah. Passes it to Mitchell. Fires from deep. A three-pointer is right on target.
There's a reason Mike Conley's teammates love playing with him. If you're open, I promise he'll find you.
On the wing, Booker. Crowder feeling it out a bit. Pass to Paul. Ayton a screen on Conley. That's a two from Paul. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Booker against Conley. About a minute and a half through the first quarter. Takes the three. And there's Bogdanovich. That's good on the assist from Conley.
Well, Bojan Bogdanovich, simply stated, has become a knockdown three-point shooter.
Suns have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. And after a down season in 2020, with some questioning if he was over the hill, Greg, Mike Conley came roaring back last season.
And the first player ever to make his All-Star debut that far into his career. It had to feel something like redemption. And I tell you, he's not done yet. Has a nice new contract to prove it.
How about that? Devin Booker says, anything you can do, I can do better. Three in the books.
Here's Bogdanovich off the left rim and out. Phoenix has gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Oh, Ayton in position. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. O'Neal kicks to Bogdanovich. Conley against Paul. Outside, Bogdanovich. Just five to shoot. Out to Conley from outside the arc. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Suns.
And a moment now to look at the numbers for Devin Booker. Averaging about 23 points per, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists. Even if you key in on him all game, he still finds a way to get his numbers.
Right, the skill, the awareness, the physical ability, it's all there. And that's what makes this guy so hard to check.
And here in the first, about 3 minutes in, Payton a screen on O'Neal. O'Neal against Crowder. No good on the shot, a bit long that time. Utah leading by 3. Conley the pass to Mitchell. Shoots over Crowder. Another miss by Utah.
Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
And the shot goes in.
That's Jay Crowder demonstrating how strong he is. He's dominating the defense with his ability to play through contact.
Phoenix shooting their first foul shot of the night. Tied up with that one.
You love a well-rounded player like Jay Crowder, cross-positional on the defensive end, a guy who has really developed into a multi-talented threat.
Now, here's Mitchell, one of the most consistent producers in the league. He's averaging around 25.5 points a game. Bogdanovich looking around for the 3. Rebounded by DeAndre Ayton.
Well, he's got a great stroke. That one almost dropped.
Crowder finds Ayton, and Ayton throws it down.
Well, you love Crowder's willingness to distribute the basketball. His vision allows him to set his teammates beautifully.
It's tipped. In the corner, it's Bridges. The dish now to Crowder. All up top, over by Conley. And the wide open shot from Crowder. Another 3 for Phoenix.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And the Jazz with some changes. Rudy Gay's checked in for Royce O'Neal. Joe Ingles comes in for Bogdanovich. And it's Clarkson in for Mitchell. And then for Phoenix, JaVale McGee comes in for DeAndre Ayton. And Johnson subbed in for Crowder. On defense, Phoenix. Here's Clarkson. They've been leaning on him for a decent chunk of their offense. He's averaging over 15 points a game. Guy is a potent offense right now.
You know what, guys? And they're playing with a certain amount of assuredness in their game. That type of confidence is what leads teams to having success.
Jazz trail by 5. Gay dishes to Conley. At the elbow, it's Gobert. And now the fast break. Bridges with the ball. The rebound by the Jazz. Clarkson right side. Ingles finds Clarkson. Back to Ingles. Ball left side. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. to stop the drought. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Let's bring up the 2K leaderboard to look at some of the players that are contributing in areas you might not expect. The top rebounding shooting guards of the past month. Fourth, Devin Booker.
And these are sort of your do-it-all guys. I mean, even if rebounding isn't necessarily a priority
for
shooting guards, it's still something that
helps your
team get wins.
Oh, no doubt about it. Their contributions on the glass provide their team with a huge bonus. As hard as they work on the glass, it makes things a lot easier for their teammates in the post. Lessens the load a little bit on those interior guys.
Emphasizing the importance of a deep bench, a few teams across the league now, Doris, are riddled with injuries.
It's why the salary cap comes into play, Kevin. Depth can be difficult to maintain, yet the elite front offices find a way year after year.
Whiteside's checked in for Rudy Gobert. And for the Suns, Landry Shamet's checked in for Booker. And it's Payne in for Chris Paul.
And much beloved in Salt Lake City, the Australian Joe Ingles is a glue guy for this team.
He's much more than that. He's absolutely one of the leaders of this team. He's outspoken on the court. He's not afraid to put an arm around a younger player and be that mentor. He's unselfish. Joe Ingles, simply put, he's a winner.
And he's got his first free throw of the game. And the first one at the line is good. Payne hits them both.
You can tell when he steps to the line the kind of confidence he has in himself. It's written all over his body language.
Clarkson for three. And the three ball is good.
Well, give Jordan Clarkson a ton of credit. He has worked tirelessly on this shot.
Bridges against Ingles. Bridges kicks to Johnson. Misses the three. Utah's gone 3-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. To the middle, and taken away by Johnson. Now here's Payne, tight defense on him. Inside. McGee against Whiteside. McGee the pass to Johnson, six to shoot. McGee is screen on cover. Here's Payne, McGee trying to break free. And again, it's the Suns missing. Clarkson outside. Gay a screen on McGee. Clarkson for three. That shot, no good. And Phoenix the other way now. Pass to Payne. Back to Bridges. Gets an open look and hits. And the Suns lead by four.
Well, a high motor player like Mikal Bridges has got to make quick decisions. Rise and fire off the catch and shoot, Mikal.
Now here's Conley. Coming in off a 10-point game, his last outing. A shot by Clarkson, no good. Ingles against Bridges. Here's Shamet. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's going to be on Rudy Gay. The Suns have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3.
And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for. Around 80% on the season.
Free throw good from Shamet. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. 40 seconds left in the first. Conley scanning the floor. Whiteside sets the pick for Conley. Feeds it to Whiteside. Stolen by McGee. There's Shamet. Hits the three-point bomb. Shamet's got five now.
Well, deliver the pass where your teammate can do something with it. Nice.
Will it go? McGee with the block, and he gets it back. Conley into the lane, and it's in there.
Wow, how about the concentration from Mike Conley? Wow, that is big time.
And so it's Phoenix heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And regarded as one of the best leaders in the game today, Chris Paul opening about how his team works together.
With anything, whether it's business, work, relationships, whatever, it's communication. And I think that's something that we're doing an amazing job of right now. And that's communicating, talking through things, and making sure, even when it gets tough, that we continue to communicate.
And with this younger team, it's got to be easier for Chris Paul to lead as that elder statesman.
Yeah, at times in the past, veteran teammates didn't appreciate his constant input. Credit these younger guys, though, for soaking it in.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Suns.
And it's been about their defense. They're playing with a frenetic pace, putting a lot of pressure on the ball handlers and forcing turnovers.
Yeah, and I think the other thing that's helped them early tonight are the points they've gotten off turnovers.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter to play. Setting the floor for the Suns. Wing pairing, it's Booker with Johnson. Ayton is the pivot, and Crowder slides in at the four. And it's Paul in at the point. For three, Mitchell. Utah getting another chance here. And slam dunk by Gobert.
That's a case where Rudy Gobert is outworking the defense, keeping the play alive, and finishing strong.
Suns leading by five. Now here's Ayton. Some good scoring numbers for him right now, averaging 17 points a game. Johnson down low, guarded by O'Neal. Johnson gets the bucket.
Yeah, well done to finish that one off.
And we're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. And Cam Johnson, a surprise pick, Doris, when he was taken 11th back in 2019. Many wondered, I recall, what the Suns saw. Now, that's not the case.
Well, that's exactly right, because most projections had him as a late first-round pick. The Suns' front office, give them credit. They saw the upside of Cameron Johnson, and boy, he is now viewed as one of the steals of that draft.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Rudy Gobert may get overlooked, but his coach understands what he means to the Utah Jazz. Quinn Snyder says, his presence on the floor gives us a chance. He's our most important player as far as how he anchors our team. He's the foundation. And Kevin, the way they win games, that's saying something.
He is a defensive player of the year multiple times. Phenomenal player. Thanks, D.A.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Mitchell kicks to Bogdanovich. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Bogdanovich has got his second bucket of the night.
I think we think of Donovan Mitchell first and foremost as a scorer, but I love seeing his passing ability come into play.
Ball against Mitchell. Now here's Paul. He's guarded closely. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got his sixth rebound on the night. Bogdanovich finds Mitchell. Back to Bogdanovich. Over Johnson. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
And there's Ayton, and that's good on the assist from Crowder. Ayton's got six.
Don't let DeAndre Ayton get comfortable. This guy is a problem on the interior.
O'Neal dishes to Mitchell. A three-pointer off the mark. Suns leading by eight. Outside Crowder. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Ayton a screen on Mitchell. Crowder the pass to Ayton. And he uses the glass on the layup. Ayton's got the lead up to 10 now for the Suns.
Well, just tremendous court recognition. DeAndre Ayton excelling in the pick and roll there.
For the Utah Jazz, they won their last contest, that game against the Denver Nuggets.
Well, on the road, you don't expect to look so comfortable on the offensive end, but that was the story of the game.
It came down to execution. No wasted possessions, and that is absolutely essential trying to win on the road.
Ingles can't get it to go. The Suns have gone 4 of 8 so far here in the second quarter. Mitchell against Booker. Back to Paul. Ayton sets the pick for Paul. Here he goes. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
And you think about the legacy of Chris Paul. You can argue he's one of the best to ever play that position.
To be honest, I don't think it's an argument. I mean, this guy top 5 in both assists and steals in the regular season. And the numbers back up the argument, guys, because wherever he has gone, the winning percentage has improved at every stop. Chris Paul is elite. Fact of the matter.
And that one misses. And you look at the 2021 draft class, just some unbelievable talent at the top.
I mean, Kay Cunningham, for me, probably is the consensus best player, but man, you got guys like Suggs and Green and Kuminga with that rare athleticism. And how about Mobley? He really defines what a modern day big is supposed to be. I mean, what more could you want?
Well, you think over the course of Chris Paul's career, he will have had a 10-year stretch where he was the best point guard in the league. But perhaps the value of his leadership qualities will be the thing he's most remembered for. Competitive spirit, pushing his team to the next level. What a career.
Bogdanovich against Ayton. And Bogdanovich kicks to Gay. Back to Bogdanovich. Five on the clock. Kicks it out to Mitchell. Bogdanovich dishes to Gay. Another miss by Utah.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And there's the call on Rudy Gobert. That's foul number 2 for him.
2 fouls already on him. That is not the way to get your minutes per game up.
A different look for Utah. Hassan Whiteside comes in for Rudy Gobert, and it's Mike Conley in for Mitchell. Landry Shamet's checked in for the Suns. Cameron Payne comes in for Chris Paul. Now here's Crowder. They lead by 11, the largest margin of the game. On the wing, Bridges. He's covered by Bogdanovich. And that one's good, Ayton.
Boy, you think about DeAndre Ayton, it's his size that comes to mind, and he understands how to utilize that to score.
Conley's shot is off. And so it's Payne with it. He'll bring it up for the Phoenix Suns. They come into this having outplayed the Clippers last game.
Yeah, and we saw them really play a determined game when it came to chasing down rebounds, getting those good second chance looks. Really loved their aggressiveness.
Listen, this is a guy who can get hot from downtown. Great to see Jay Crowder being aggressive when given the opportunity.
And the Suns making a change here. McGee's checked in. Now that we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for the last handful of seasons for Rudy Gobert.
He's really made that a focus of his game these past few years, and it's paid big-time dividends for him. He's become a much better rebounder, and it's increased his value as a player by leaps and bounds.
Gay scanning the floor. And the foul called on Bojan Bogdanović. That is his first foul of the game.
Oh, great defense. They anticipated the play and got there first.
And it's Phoenix's ball. They're on a 14-3 run right now. Stolen by Clarkson. Shamet with the steal. Bridges. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to go on Bojan Bogdanović.
But you can see the confidence that Mikal Bridges has in himself. This guy's going to take pride in going up strong, forcing the issue, and getting himself to the foul line.
For Phoenix, they have made 6 of their 7 attempts at the line in this one.
Two.
And that one falls for Bridges.
Well, what you love about Mikal Bridges is he is going to accept whatever his coaches and team ask of him. This is what's allowed him to be successful.
So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. It's going to be out of bounds. The Suns will retain possession. And a quick look at how the Suns' schedule is shaping up. On Saturday, they'll face off against Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat. And then on Tuesday, they'll tip off a road trip in Toronto where they'll take on the Raptors.
And, you know, nobody loves playing on the road, but it does offer a good chance to see exactly what your team is made of. This team is going to find out a lot about itself over the next stretch of games.
Bridges for 3. And it's Rudy Gay with the rebound. Jazz trailed by 17. Conley with it. And there's the pass to Gay. And here's Bogdanović. Whiteside a screen on Bridges. Can they get it? Bogdanović finds Whiteside. Good for the basket. Starting off 1 for 1 with that shot.
Well, how about the court awareness from Bogdanović showing off his ability to find the open man, Kev?
Suns leading by 15. Now Shamet. 5 points in the game. Passes it to Payne. No good that time. Good work defensively by Conley. Utah's gotten into trouble with the 3-ball in the second quarter. Only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. Clarkson passes to Bogdanović. Conley. That ball. Nice feed that time from Bogdanović. Conley's got his second basket of the night. 51 seconds left in the first half. Here's Payne. He had 10 points in the win against the Clippers. And that one's good, Shamet.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
You know exactly what that takes. It takes energy, it takes activity, it takes intensity.
Now here's Conley. It's over Payne, and the shot is long. 3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. He kicks it to Bridges. Pass to Shamet. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. ...11 seconds left in the second quarter. Clarkson taking his time here. Shoots over Shamet. DeAndre Ayton, he has been the guy making things happen for the Phoenix Suns. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Here with head coach Quinn Snyder. Coach, what adjustments are you going to do in the second half?
You just got to keep playing, keep taking the shots, and that's not the issue as much as us not executing on offense. When we don't score, sometimes our defense lags as well.
Everybody wants to see the ball go in the basket first, right? Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Hey there, everybody. Shaq says hi. Kenny says hi, too. Yes, we are in the midst of the NBA season and a perfect time to see how things are coming together in the West.
You know, for Phoenix, they've been awesome so far this year. That was expected from the good analysts who know what they're talking about. We've got one on this panel, and it's called Shaq O'Neal. You don't know about the other two.
And right now, let's talk about that monster first half for the Phoenix Suns.
What a brilliant, unselfish half of basketball they just played. Their ball movement was absolutely impeccable. All in all, just beautiful basketball to watch.
That's all for us. Now it's time to send it back to Kevin Harlan for the beginning of the third quarter.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. DeAndre Ayton has been sensational.
The way he was able to finish on the block was incredible there in that first half.
It felt like his work on the interior really gave this offense a boost. Let's see if he can dominate the rest of the way.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Conley is the point with Mitchell as the two guard. Avdija and Hachimura in the forward position. And it's Gobert in at the five. It's the group right now for Utah.
Well, a guard has got to come with physical intensity on the interior, and Devin Booker does just that.
And so Conley will bring the ball up for the Utah Jazz. They trail by 18.
And, you know, Booker might have been a volume shooter, at least early in his career, but now he's a legit number one option for an offense.
Now, here's Bridges, following the miss by Michael Conley. Booker with no one around. Another one falls for Phoenix.
My goodness, what a move there to lose the defender. Got him on his heels, and then he made it look easy from there on in.
Mitchell with it, now guarded by Ayton. The shot by Mitchell, no good. And Craig, the efficiency for Booker has grown over the years.
And no longer forcing shots. Takes what's available to him, and I believe he can be the leading scorer on a championship caliber team. So close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing it safe. Listen to the reaction of the fans after that call.
A little over a minute gone here in the second half. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Kicks it to O'Neal. The Jazz with another miss.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Just lucky he was off.
Well, this is the kind of shot we've come to expect him to make. He's got to be upset with that one.
Now here's Conley. On the wing, Bridges. Outside, Crowder. And it's Royce O'Neal with the foul. That's his first foul. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Paul with the ball. Now defended by Gobert. And that one's good, Ayton.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Jazz have gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second half. Conley, the pass to O'Neal. Pass to Gobert. On the wing, Mitchell. O'Neal a screen on Booker. Here's Mitchell, four on the clock. O'Neal from long range. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
You know, he could have looked to score that himself, but in this particular instance, the advantage is playing inside out.
Phoenix leading by 21. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Ayton kicks to Paul. Outside Crowder. Ayton sets the pick for Crowder. And it's Mike Conley with the rebound.
Well, when you've been struggling as he has, you love that your teammates have really stepped up and taken the challenge.
Mitchell against Booker. Gobert with a screen on Booker. The drive by Mitchell. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Gobert has a thin frame, but make no mistake, he is physical and he relishes contact.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Ayton sets the pick for Paul. Over Conley. The shot by Paul, no good. Jazz trailed by 19. Here's Mitchell. That ball. Nice feed that time from Bogdanovich. Mitchell's got 5 points so far.
You can see the kind of confidence Donovan Mitchell has in that handle. His ability to navigate off the dribble drive. Nice.
For Phoenix, they've gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. Ayton a screen on Mitchell. The drive by Booker. Good. And the Suns lead by 19.
Well, I absolutely love the way this guy has controlled the pace tonight. They've been able to play the style they want.
Utah has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Mitchell passes to Conley. O'Neal kicks to Conley. Good work defensively by Paul. Phoenix leading by 19. Booker looking around. Over Mitchell. No good from Booker. For Utah, they've gone 3-8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock in that rhythm. Bogdanovich passes to O'Neal. Bridges against Bogdanovich. The Jazz need to get off a shot here. Conley gets the bucket.
Well, Mike Conley, we know his pre-shot preparation is excellent. Catch and shoot bucket, yes, sir.
So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Whiteside's checked in for Rudy Gobert. Gay comes in for O'Neal. Joe Ingles, he's checked in for Bogdanovich. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. A big group substitution here for Phoenix. JaVale McGee's checked in for DeAndre Ayton. Johnson comes in for Jay Crowder. Landry Shamet's checked in for Bridges. And it's Payne in for Devin Booker. And so it's Payne with it. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. The biggest lead of the game was 24 points. All against Mitchell. Shamet on the wing. 8 points for him. Nice ball movement by Phoenix. The three, and Whiteside sends it back. Here's Clarkson. No good on the shot. Now the Suns take it the other way. Paul, left side. Payne finds Johnson. Down low, here's McGee. That one falls, coming off the Johnson feed. McGee's got his first bucket in this one.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
To me, this is simply stated, been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
McGee with the block, and he recovers it. Hands of the ball is out of bounds. Clarkson touched it last. And now a glance at the 2K leaderboard with a list of the NBA's top assist men over the past 10 games. Number one, Chris Paul.
And those games have seen him dropping more dimes than you might have thought possible.
Suns leading by 18.
And they call him Spider because of that long wingspan, 6'10 at present, but standing 6'1. Mitchell needs that to compete defensively at that shooting guard position.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, the Utah Jazz last season was elite at both ends of the floor. Sixth Man of the Year winner Jordan Clarkson says, three things we've been doing well are playing fast, sharing the basketball, and defense. We're playing a fun style of basketball and just keep racking up the wins. Guys?
They are fun to watch, and a handful. D.A. thanks. Offensive rebound, McGee. And denied, he sends it right off the glass. Ingles with the ball. He's picked up by Paul. Ingles kicks to Mitchell. Clarkson outside. The shot comes out. Now the Suns take it the other way.
I'll tell you, no matter what he does, he can't find his rhythm, and you get the sense he's starting to press a little bit.
McGee finds Paul. Johnson, the pass to Shamet. And out of bounds as Utah gains possession. Bridges is checked in for the Suns. And it's Utah's ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Mitchell with it. He's picked up by Paul. Takes it from 10. And that one's good, Mitchell. Mitchell's got his third basket of the night right there.
Well, this guy's so consistent at staying engaged on the offensive end. Is Mitchell a shoot-first guard? You bet.
Here's Paul. And again, it's the Suns missing. Gay dishes to Clarkson. Here's Mitchell. And he converts the layup. Mitchell's got 9.
The combination of power, aggression, and frame, and a willingness to embrace contact, Mr. Donovan Mitchell delivers.
And so it's Phoenix, up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been terrific in this game. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. Jazz trail by 12 on the court for the Suns. The star backcourt of Paul and Booker are out there. Hop it forward, they'll have Bridges and Crowder. And it's Ayton in at the center position.
Well, you can give them a steady diet of pick and roll, because if Jordan Clarkson gets downhill, it's trouble.
Phoenix has gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight, 50% exactly. Here's Ayton, rebounded by Clarkson. Utah shooting at 36% on the night. They've got to step it up offensively. Ingles against Bridges. And the shot is good. The Phoenix lead has been cut down to 8 on the bucket from Ingles.
I'll tell you, Ingles is just such a pro. This guy is unafraid despite the defense.
And here's Phoenix. The biggest lead of the game was 24 points. Now here's Ayton. Ayton sets the pick for Paul. Over Gobert. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And with Chris Paul, he makes this team work, gets the most out of his teammates, and has done that wherever he's played.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Phoenix.
fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
Two shots.
Now, the other thing they've done tonight is work the ball into the paint. Plenty of their points coming from close range.
And that one falls for Paul. As you said, Paul's teams often overachieve in the standings.
People still underestimate his impact. Sets up and improves his guys as well as anyone, and he's the engine to this whole operation.
The Jazz making a switch here. Bogdanovich has checked in, so he gets them both. Fourth quarter just getting started, 1 minute in the books. Paul against Conley. Dishes to Ingles. Driving to the basket. A shot off that time. Bridges with some nice defense. For three, Booker. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Here's O'Neal. It doesn't go for him. And so it's Crowder with it. He'll bring it up for the Suns. It's a 10-point game. Here's Ayton. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. O'Neal passes to Conley. Gobert the screen. To the inside. It's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got three assists in the game.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Now here's Crowder. Booker left side. Over Ingles. And the Suns miss again. Jazz trail by eight. Here's Bogdanovich. And Bogdanovich throws it down.
How about the intensity of Bogdanovich? A superb dunk off the drive.
Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. Booker against Ingles. The drive by Booker. Over Gobert. Gobert with the block. Bogdanovich against Paul. Conley kicks to Bogdanovich. Gobert down low. He's against Bridges. And with that shot, the Suns' lead is cut down to four on the bucket from Rudy Gobert. Fourth quarter keeps moving right along. 3 minutes gone so far. Phoenix calls timeout.
And looking to stop this run and get back on track.
Really needs to settle his guys down right now and get them refocused.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, guys, I had a chance to listen to what Monty Williams discussed with his players. He's encouraged where they are at this point in the game, but he told his guys, things can turn in a blink. What we need to do is execute the rest of the way. So we'll see if they can finish this one off, Kevin.
All right, David, thanks. Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Booker with it. Bridges outside. And the foul called on Bojan Bogdanović. That's his third foul of the game. Ayton finds Booker. In the corner, Crowder with it. Lock at six. Into the lane. And it's sent back by O'Neal.
And after shooting over 45% in that first half, which helped them build the lead, it hasn't been quite as easy for them here in the second.
Now here's Gobert. Ingles passes to Bogdanović. Gobert with a screen on Bridges. Bogdanović, and he comes up with the deuce.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
The Suns have gone 0-6 in the fourth quarter. Disastrous start to the period. The pass to Booker from the arc. Hits it from three-point range. Booker's got 9 points now in just the second half.
Wow, he looks like a completely different player in this half. He's found his rhythm.
Outside, Bogdanović. Gobert with a screen on Bridges. And the rejection by Ayton.
Boy, Ayton's reach is absolutely incredible. Great anticipation. That is nice defense.
Here's Paul. Booker trying to free himself up. Paul's shot is off.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
And there's the call on DeAndre Ayton. That is his first foul of the game. Mitchell, he's checked in for the Jazz. Utah with the ball. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. Nice ball movement by Utah. Here's Conley. Good work defensively by Crowder.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Ayton, Gobert with the block.
Defensively, few players have had a bigger impact than Rudy Gobert. That combination of energy and length and commitment, so good defensively.
Suns leading by 5. Booker finds Crowder. Shot clock at 6. No good there. Gobert with the defensive effort.
I'll tell you, even though he's not playing his best basketball, the team has played well and picked it up. I love it.
Mitchell with it. Now guarded by Crowder. And there's the foul on Jay Crowder. That's his first foul. Payne, he's checked in for Paul. Here's Gobert. Mitchell outside. Knocks down the three ball.
Such a clutch shooter. This guy lives for these kinds of moments and delivers.
It's Payne with the ball. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. Passes to Bridges. O'Neal against Crowder. On the wing, Booker. Looking for Ayton. He gets it in there. Over Gobert. And Ayton the bucket on the assist by Booker.
Guys, I like how assertive DeAndre Ayton is looking right now. This is allowing him to stay hot out there.
Mitchell against Booker. There's O'Neal with the three. And the Jazz, another three.
And those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball game.
There's a minute 47 left in the game. Booker against Mitchell. Now here's Booker. He's covered closely. Can't hit from front. Crucial possession with time ticking down.
Yeah, an opportunity to take the lead on this possession.
And that one's good, Mitchell.
I tell you, at times, guarding Donovan Mitchell has got to feel overwhelming defensively. When he starts to go with the floater, look out.
Phoenix has gone 6 of 12 from outside. A very nice 50% mark, shooting the three ball well. Mitchell against Booker. Can't hit from in close. Utah leading. Mitchell left side. That one, no good. Now the Suns take it the other way. Bridges finds Ayton. Back to Bridges. Mitchell against Booker. To the wing right side. Ayton trying to break free.
And you can tell right there, the defense is totally fine with him shooting that. That's not his game.
Sweet move. The putback.
Oh, and a nice job of turning that miss into 2 points on the tip-in.
Hustle points, I believe they call them. Hustle points right there.
Can't afford any wasted possessions down the stretch.
I'll tell you, they better come up with some points on every possession from now on.
To the paint. Here's Ayton to end the run. Utah with the rebound. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
and so they choose to intentionally foul. The first one, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
What an athletic lineage from Mike Conley. Of course, Mike Sr., triple jump gold medalist at the 92 games. Mike Conley, for over a decade, has been a tremendous NBA player.
So he gets them both, and it's a five-point game.
You've got to show composure, and he comes through right when the team needs him most.
We've got 13 seconds left to play in the final quarter.
And this is what dominating the glass looks like. He just cannot be contained.
Wow, what a performance. And he's not just winning with physical ability. He's winning with anticipation.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
Gets the first, and that increases their lead to six. Second one is good, hitting both at the line, and it's a seven-point game. He hits Crowder on the wing. And that time, also a missed shot. We see the Jazz get the win here. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Rudy, your impact on the game defensively, always something to watch. What's your approach at that end?
Just try to win games, you know, and my teammates put a lot of trust in me, being aggressive on the boards and try to be aggressive at the rim. And, you know, when we play as a team like we do tonight, it's tough to beat us.
You were in full Stifel Tower mode tonight, man. Congrats. Back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Rudy Gobert.